All right, this starts the pre-trip inspection of the 96 Ford bus here, Gary. And from first glance, it looks pretty decent. Bumper straight. Let's see here. That might be where somebody's hit it or they tried to paint. It's got a wrinkle in it. Either way, it's not bad. The grill is intact, no cracks in the grill. The mirrors, it's got what you call those cat eye mirrors, I believe. They look good, they're solid. It's got headlights and turn signals. This mirror is good. Frame is, it's a little rusty. Not terrible, but a little bit of rust. There's the slack adjuster and the brake chamber, shock absorber. The tire, the front tire, they have very nice deep tread on them. I get my finger, which is, I'll say they're better than any of the ones on my buses. So they're 11R, 11R 22.5. They got the big tires on here. They're Goodyear. It's got a hub oiler and the pieces in it where you can fill it up. Looks good, doesn't look damaged. It's spoke wheels, 6-spoke on the front. That's the 9,000 pound front axle. Like I said, tires looks good. They really do look good. I'd take them in a heartbeat, put them on my bus. Right here is a real common area for some rust to be right there on the bus because they don't put the mud flap there, but you can because there's a bracket for it. Still looks good. Yeah, it's still looking pretty good. It's got a block heater. There's the, I'd assume that's the cord for the block heater. It's got crossover mirrors on it with that little round one on top. I'd like to have that on my MVP. they're solid. They look good. And they're not broken. The door, I'll put it in the lock position. Door looks good. Here we go. Door looks good. It shuts. It's not rusted at the bottom. It'll need, if you're concerned about these, the door buffers. They're rotted and wore out from use, I'm sure. And here's some damage right here at this little corner piece thing. It's like somebody backed in over something wrong ways, because I don't know how in the world you dent that unless you back in something wrong ways and pull it out. That's some damage right there, but not too bad. Hell, you can just get you another piece, put that on there. You might be able to beat that out. Here's the fuel tank. It says NC State biodiesel. Diesel on. Let's see if it's got a cap. Oh, it does have a cap. Yep, looks pretty good. That's good. It's got side marker turn signals, and the lens there is clear. I guess it's so faded from the sun, it's just turned itself clear. Thomas emblem looks good. No visible damage on the rub rails on the right side. No visible damage. Everything looks pretty good from right here. It's got black windows. It's tall headroom. Marker lights and everything looks good. From this side of the bus, looks pretty good. You can see right here where they scraped off the lettering. It says Fleet Services. NC State. Yeah, and NC State University Fleet Services, where they scraped off the vinyl letters. Back tires. Well, here's a little scrape right here. Nothing bad. Just a little scrape. Yes, there's some little scraping or paint flaking off the rub rail. Back tires are just as good as the front. They're got lots of tread on them. They look good. Back one looks, the inner dual looks good too. They're, like I said, they're not brand new, but they're not super old. And they feel good and they got air in them. The rims look good. So I got 7.5 inch rim, 22.5 by 7.5. Spoke looks good. The axle ain't leaking. The clamps look good. It's a little rusty, but paint them up and they'll look good. Valve stems on the tires look like they've not been bent. So that wheel looks good. Tires are good. And they are also 11R 22.5, so that's all got 11Rs all the way around. So, oh, well, missed this little bit of damage up here. If I didn't miss that. There's some scrape right there. And I guess they scraped whatever and replaced the light with one of those different kind of lights. It's a scrape. It's not terrible painted over it, and it probably won't show up as bad. Scrape right there on top. So there's damage right there to the front right there, and scrape up top on the right side. So far, nothing majorly wrong. Bumper is white. It's got a turn down tip on the exhaust. The exhaust feels a little loose, but it's probably okay. I'll get up there and look from the back. It's looks pretty good. Doesn't have any load lights on it or warning lights at the top. A little bit of rust spots there in the center, right there. A few flaked off rust spots. Back door looks nice and straight, not bent or anything. Bumper's pretty good, no bends in it. Lights all look pretty good. The lenses and everything look good. Nothing bad. Looks pretty good back here. Well, there's some damage also right here on the marker light there. I don't know how they did that. They must have some gates or bridges or something for them to hit up there at NC State. But it's kind of bent in. You can probably, well, I don't know if you know. I don't know how to fix that. Probably Bondo it would be my guess. That's only damage up top right there on the left side. Looks pretty good down the side.
Small little bump on the bumper.
Yeah. There's is that a bump? That actually looks like it's there. Or might be a scrape. I don't know. That's just a scrape and the paint flake. And you cover that up, it'll look good. Other than that, this side... what I'm looking at, this side looks pretty good, other than that little damage up there. Again, it just says NC State University Fleet Services, where they peeled it off on the side. No mud flaps. These tires over here, still good. Still look good. See my camera focus, here you go. Still look good. The mounting holes for the mud flaps look good. Spoke looks good. Hub is not leaking. Spokes, like I said, the clamps look good. The valve stems ain't bent. Rim looks good. It's got a balancer on it. There you go. That's also good. But the back tires are really good. The tires probably all around are really good. They've done a good job of keeping the tires up at least. Battery box looks good. No cracks or major rusting. Got two batteries. The tray will slide out. I ain't gonna pull it, but it looks really good in there. Not rusty at all. Batteries look good. Door looks good. Door shuts. Like I said, looks good on this side. Again, the left side side marker, the lens is faded off from the sun. I know that was supposed to be amber, so you'll need to replace that. Mirrors on this side, the crossover mirrors look good. The driver window looks good. I mean, a little dirty, but give it a bath, it'll look really good. Your step bracket looks good. Your hood clamp looks good. Secure, I'll open it in a minute. Front tire still looks good. 11R spokes look good. The hub is there and it's not leaking. Clamps are good. Rim's good. Valve stem ain't bent. Looks good. Window. Front windshield looks good. It's, like I said, it just could use a bath. The windshield wiper bracket things, our arms are a little rusty, but paint them up a little bit and they'll look better. All right, I'm going to open the hood now. And we will start it here in just on the cables that won't let it, the hood fall. They look good and fresh. They don't look rusty. Hood, inner part of the hood looks good. Two horns over there. Everything looks good. All right, now this is a 5.9. It's got a serpentine belt on it, and the belt looks really good. It looks pretty fresh. I mean, it's not old, but it's not probably brand new, but it looks pretty fresh. Fan, cooling fan, it's good and tight. None of the blades are missing. It spins freely. Radiator, inner part of the radiator looks good, not rusted out. Radiator looks good. There's intake for it right there. That looks good. Engine, from what I can see, looks okay. There's filter. Well, that looks all right. From what I can see, it looks pretty good. There she is. Is that a water separator, I'm thinking? Maybe? Fuel water separator, maybe? It's got the windshield wiper tank. It's got fluid in it. There's the chassis sticker data plate. It's 29,000 GVR. Looks good. Hoses look good. Here's the reservoir tank on the top there. Let me get over here and see. So far, this bus is looking pretty good, other than some body damage. I haven't seen anything yet that would lead me to believe it wouldn't pass inspection. Steering box looks good. The drag link there looks good, or the tie rod looks good. No, it's not the tie rod, it's the drag link. There's pitman arm looks good. Everything looks good and greasy. Air brake, slack adjuster looks good. Brake drum looks good. These hoses are not the newest, but they are probably going to be okay. Oil. Check the oil. Hopefully not. Yep, hands filthy. Oh, there we go. And let's see here. It's past full on the oil, and the oil doesn't look black as hell, so it looks pretty decent. Oil looks pretty fresh. It's good. That's a good sign. It's full, and the oil is pretty fresh. So, and the like I said, the hoses, the high pressure hoses that go from the pump to the gearbox, are not new, but they look okay. New filter there. That's probably a fuel filter, if I had to guess. Because it's got a little drainer on the bottom of it. I don't know what that blue thing is right there. Don't know. No, that's a governor. That's a governor for the air compressor. There you go. That's the air compressor pump right there. Here's you go. Here's some specs for the engine. 190 horsepower, 2300 RPMs, 5.9. There you go, 190 horse. Top of the motor, the fuel lines for the injectors look pretty good. They're not rusted and cracked and everything. All the hoses and everything, from what I can see, they're not new, but they're okay. Like I said, all the lines look okay. You know, there's the, I believe that's the power steering fluid. And it's full, and it's full, looks good. That's good. Power steering reservoir is good. Coolant, believe it needs some coolant, because it's not at the AdMark thing right there. Could be over full, and I'm just not catching it. Let me shake it. Actually, yeah, it's full, it's over full, it's good. Yeah, coolant's good. Everything's looking good, so I guess we can go ahead and start it up now. But honestly, I have not seen anything on it yet that would lead me to cause it not pass inspection. Everything on it is minor, so the thing is started up. So I'll go in here and crank it up. So here's the inside. You go in, steps are not rusty. That's another thing. Yeah, step weld is actually decent, not as rusted as my MVP. Like I said, it's not the best. I mean it's good. You know, it's not excellent, but it's nothing showing through, certainly. So it's good. to me, it's good. Inside looks really good and a little dusty. So I guess if you buy this bus, they'll give you some Type F power steering fluid or transmission fluid, and that's, what is that? SuperTech, super fluid, that's 30 weight oil. All right. You have to please pick up yourself after you get on this bus. It's got the compartment there, the big panel compartment thing, which is missing the little black handle, but it opens. And it's full of useful things, actually. Is that a jack? That is a jack. That is a hydraulic jack, buddy. That's an old one. Old Sears 5-ton jack. Fire extinguisher. Hey, don't say anything, Gary, to anybody. Just take everything in it. All right. Mirror is good and secure. Not broken. It's got the visor, sun visor thing behind it. It ain't broke. Fan is there. It's got one fan. It's got the acoustic ceiling with the racks. Head to the luggage racks on top thing. It's got the lower type seating. The seats aren't as high as the ones in my MVP. Like I said, acoustic ceiling, got racks, got black windows, and none of them are cracked, except one at the back there, out of a big square one at the back. So I'll go back here. Bus also comes with your own fogger if you buy it. There's one of the emergency or roof hatches, roof escapes. Don't know why they have this rag on there. Could it be leaking? We don't know. Don't know. But the escape, the hatch looks good. Yeah, it really looks good. It's got the dome lights look good. They are intact. There's 2, 4, 6 of them. And also, this rear escape hatch just looks good. It's the old style, but it looks good. Yeah. Back door, see, they've removed probably 1 or 2, 3 seats, actually, I believe. No, two seats. You can see the holes in the floor there, down in the ground. You can see daylight through there, which means you're going to have to probably fix that, because I wouldn't want the rain or moisture coming in the floor. They took out 2 rows of seats on this side, on the left side, I guess for storage or whatever, and they've took out 1 row at the back here. But it looks good. The back door, emergency door, looks good. Pad thing getting messed up. Handle looks good. The only crack in any of the windows is back here on this one, and it's all the way through. It's a crack right there and a crack right here. That's the only crack in this windshield. But again, why wouldn't that not pass inspection? I mean, you know, what's the problem there? So other than that, I guess Ben, we can crank it up if you want, because I'll go outside and watch the engine while you crank it up. I'll show you how to crank it.
All right,
it's a neutral.
It is a neutral.
All right, I'll show you what to do. This bus probably don't have any kind of thing where it says wait to start, you know, like Bluebird. So just probably just first start. No, don't touch the gas. Just see if it cranks. And like I said, before you crank, there's all the switches and everything. Very Spartan. It's got the cigarette lighter there. Looks good. Everything looks intact. Data plate, like I said, is faded off. I was struggling to read it, but that's whatever. So turn the key. Makes the low. That's the buzzer. Low oil or low air light one. But it's full of air. It's got over 90 pounds. Parking brakes over there. It's making the noise. So when I get out here at the engine, just go ahead and crank it till it cranks.
All right.
Okay. All right, fire away. Oh yeah. Oh buddy. That fires right up. And it sounds good. It sounds smooth. To be a cold start, he started today. Of course, it's not very cold. It's probably in the 70s right now. Oh, it sounds good. Running smooth. Fan's working good. Belt's working good. Good sounding engine.
looking good. Sounding good. It's got an air dryer on it, just scared me to death. I just heard it spit, so. A little bit of smoke coming out of the exhaust. Not bad, though. It is a cold start. Let's see here. Just a little bit of blue. Smells good. Smells like a diesel. Got a little bit of smoke coming out of it. I don't know if you can see it. Just a little bit of black smoke coming out, just a little bit, you know. Probably a warm up, that'd probably go away. So, I mean, it's not bad, you know. So what, let me look up under here. Oh, well, it's not rusted. Oh, let's look up under here now. Oh no, not rusting bad at all. It's just very, looks very good. And that hanger I thought was kind of loose. It's just, yeah. Horn works. So it looks really good. Oh. Yeah, there's the back of it there, or the cross member, the shackle, or the hanger, whatever you call it. Drive shaft looks pretty good. You can see it. It's not rusty, it looks greased. There's a step well thing, a gas tank, fuel tank. So it's very minimal with rust on the bottom. So again, it's let's look at the gauges.
That's what I'm looking at too. Everything looks good.
Looking good?
Yeah. It's got a good tank of gas.
It's got 3/4 of the way full.
Running cool right now. Got
oil pressure, good oil pressure right in the center. Good voltage. It popped up, I heard it spit.
Yep. Sitting at about 115.
This is a good bus. This is a very good bus. Windshield wipers work. Yeah, try some switches. There you go. Yeah, push that one. That should be the fluid thing. Should squirt the fluid.
Let me get the fluid.
No, it's full on fluid. Just hold it for a little while. See if it. Sometimes it has to.
There we go.
Hey, there you go. The window washer is working. It's spraying. Interior lights, all of them work.
Yep. We have fans.
Fan, driver fans. I don't know why they turned it that way, but it works.
Got the heater.
Yep, low and high.
And then defrost.
Let me feel. Turn the defrost on. Yeah, both of them work.
Yep.
Both side defrosters work. This is a good bus. Gary, you need to bid on this bus. All right, put it in reverse, Ben, so if it has a beeper on it.
That's the deal breaker.
Yeah, yeah.
You gotta have a backup.
I don't hear a beeper, but that's easily fixed.
Gary, you can't get this bus. It don't have a beeper.
Yeah. All right. It's the shift to put it in drive, just to see if it everything's working. Yeah, it goes in the drive. All right, put it in neutral. Yeah, everything is working. Your phone fall off. Yeah, everything's working. No warning lights are on or any caution lights or anything. Everything looks good. Brakes work. Low air lights working. Beeper's working. Buzzer's working. See the air compressor catching up and popping up. It's popping. All right, it went off.
It goes pretty fast too.
Yeah, it's a good compressor. Let it pump up and we'll do the, I'll go ahead and cut the video off, but we'll do the low air brake, the lab test.
Lab test.
Yeah. We'll see if everything works. All right, Gary, in summary, I'm going to wrap it up because it'll take me 5 hours to upload this video. it's working good. This is a good bus. You can hear the engine running again. I'll back up so you can just see it. Still smoking a little bit, but when it's probably just cold. I'll say when it warms up and you get it on the road, it'll probably clear up. Sounds good to me. Nothing I've seen raises a red flag. So I don't know why it wouldn't pass inspection. I don't know if somebody just said that to say it, but I have seen nothing yet that would let me believe it wouldn't pass inspection. I mean, and I know some pretty good guys that would pass it for me anyway, but if I took this one to a legitimate place, there's no reason it shouldn't pass inspection, because everything works and everything looks good. So I recommend you get this bus, Gary. This is a good bus. It's a little rough around the edges. Like I said, just clean it. And like I said, it's white, so it's already primed for you to paint it whatever you want. So it's perfect. So I think this is a great buy. So just like I said, just if you have to bid $20,000, just get it. It's a good bus. So all right, Mr. Ben Johnson. We'll see you later. Thank you. And thank you, everybody, for watching. And as always, have a good one.